Hello!
Welcome.
This is Provanjo.
How are we doing?
Got a beer for our magic rock on human cannonball, triple India Pale Ale. Purchased it from Salted Wines. When I bought it, it's kind of expensive, but I knew there was a special reason for it, but didn't know the reason until yesterday. But as Andrew, you see, Jenny's no longer with us. So, Jenny.
Do I tell you?
Yeah. So Andrew, pause it. My first ever BB Barfly. When Brian Becker,
was a staff making this for him.
First asked me how I wanted my first BB Barfly design. I said I wanted two things on it. One handle, one thing I love to do, and second handle, one thing that's closest to my heart. Jenny. Really. Now, within the first 4 days, the BB Barfly ended like this because I tried to do the tricks. One of the tricks is basically from that position to take it that position. Now, I was testing it on my bed. It hit my hand, hit my metal bedpost, and Jenny, who was sleeping, suddenly got a sudden surprise. It hit the wall above Jenny, and she ran over and says, "What are you doing?" But that's the first, when I first got my first BB Barfly. But anyway, on to the beer. First time I tried the human cannonball, just reminded me of Mango's Rubicon.
Yeah.
But this is the unhuman cannonball. 12%, it's a big beer, so.
I can almost Jenny. Smell it from it. You don't need to get down for it, it's so strong. It's just like, almost smelling like mango lassi or something, you know what I mean?
Yeah, almost like passion fruit, guava, almost like all the Rubicon flavours in one glass, but it does smell nice.
Smells lovely.
It's like piney smell, bit of a nice stuffy fruit.
It's a lovely aroma though.
You do not get the alcohol in the smell, just trying to generate it. It's very white.
Smells like that, it's totally
so. Just try. It's really cloudy. But anyway, Jenny.
Two. Chin.
You get the alcohol a bit on the taste. Piney, the tropical fruits that we mentioned earlier.
It almost feels like caramelized mangoes.
It's very warming on the chest,
more
into the alcohol.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, like with whiskey, you get a warm chest. You know, that sort of feeling. But a flavour of caramelised mangoes or something.
It does remind me of almost the Colonel Centennial, which was also almost like chicken gravy. Very nice, tasty though. As was the human cannonball. We've not had many magic rock bottles, and the ones that we've had not been great. Mainly, I don't know. I think it was the early stage of magic rock. The ones that we've had in cask not been that great.
Well, I had the.
But the magic eight ball is very nice.
Yeah, is that the black one?
Yeah, the black IPA.
Yeah. Oh, I got that on bottle, and that was superb.
Yeah, you've had that in bottle. But they've been alright. but we've not really paid attention to Spanish milk that much. Even though we do a love our Yorkshire beers.
It is really nice.
It is nice.
Can't have a few, too many of these. It's like one of these will just do you.
It has got like a piney aftertaste.
What?
Nice cloy.
Was it triple IPA? Yeah.
You get pine, like a musty pine smell.
Yeah. It's a very strong, sticky taste, isn't it? Almost. Yeah.
It's like, it's really nice drinking, and then the alcohol comes, and then the abundance of flavour.
Yeah. It's very powerful in the beer, though. Yeah.
But it's a lovely beer. But it does have a weird aftertaste. I'm not too keen on. But it's a nice beer. Would I pay what I paid? It would have been £16 sterling. And it's the special beer. But Soft Tail Wines, there's the cap. Give me it for £13. So it's not that bad, to be fair. 12% beer, big bottle.
Yeah.
And very limited release. But yeah.
Are you going to do a bottle test?
I was thinking. But one of the big things that I do like about Mad Rock is the artwork. I think each of the brewers have got their own
style or
character. I think they've got their own character. But bottle test of the Unhuman Cannonball. Jenny. It's strangely very drinkable from bottle.
Yeah, it is.
Now, they say the reason you don't enjoy the bottle, drinking from the bottle that well, is because it cancels out the nose. Because most of the taste is from the smell.
It gives it a musty taste as well.
But I'm saying this, but I prefer it from the bottle. Because you get just the full-on taste and no aroma.
Yeah.
But then it comes, when you pull it away, you get the little bit of aroma from the bottle.
I think what it is, it's just, you only concentrate on one element there, because you cut out the smell, don't you? It all comes concentrated on the taste.
Yeah.
Because when you try like that, as soon as you get to that position, you've got the aroma.
Get smell, and then taste.
Yeah.
But either way, it's a really nice beer, and I'm glad to have paid what I paid.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I'm actually my own brother. It's just a shame. Jenny's not in a chair. But she's gone to a better place, because this world sucks. You take care.
Goodbye.
Thanks, Jenny. Goodbye.